This is a television colour camera. It's pretty heavy. 208 pounds of brilliant, sophisticated mechanism. This is Roly Looker. He is pretty heavy too, looking at him. I should reckon about 150 pounds of brilliant, sophisticated mechanism, right?
Right.
Anyway, the thing about this camera is that it is heavy, but it can do quite a lot of things. Let's test it, shall we? I'm going to walk round you, Roly.
Okay, sir.
Twice, pretty fast. Can you follow me?
Yeah.
Right, here we go. I'm flying, in fact. Come on, catch up.
That's it, I'm afraid.
Ah, you see, that is it. Because what happened?
Well, we've got this very heavy-duty camera cable, you see, that takes the power from the camera and to it. And it's got wound around the pedestal.
So you'd have to go all the way around the other way.
In fact, I can't pan left any further.
Is there anything else that you as a cameraman would like to see happen with this camera? I mean, anything that's missing as far as you're concerned?
Well, it's very heavy, and of course the size. We've got four in the studio, and from time to time you get really congested, you know.
Bump into one.
Yeah.
Of course, we mustn't knock it all together, because there is one marvellous thing about it, because what Roly is seeing now, you are seeing at home immediately. There's no processing involved. Look, come and have a look. If you look through where Roly's looking through, you can see what he's seeing. But the one thing is that it's missing manoeuvrability.
Well, Sue, I've got the manoeuvrable camera here. This one I can move anywhere. I can see anything in the studio. It's a film camera. It's the sort of thing that we use twice a week on Magpie when we're out on stories. The trouble with it is that although I can see anything, no one else can, because the film, which is in the magazine here, has to go off to be processed just like snapshots do. And that takes a few days, so this really isn't quite the answer, I'm afraid.
Perhaps this is, Mick, because this is a portable television camera. If you move out the way there, I'm not very used to it at the moment. It has almost all the flexibility of a film camera, yet you get live pictures. And if I pan all the way around the studio, standing on the same spot, you can see just how flexible and versatile it is. Although I'm not terribly good as a cameraman, but Dave Rogers, who's a senior outside broadcast cameraman, certainly is. There you are, Dave.
Thank you, David.
You were breathing heavily a bit there watching me film.
I was, yeah.
Because it's quite a valuable camera. Now, were they able to make it supportable compared with the big studio cameras?
Well, what they did was to take the lens and just the other small pieces that go to producing the first part of the picture before it goes into the electronics, and putting most of the electronics into this box here, which can be carried on the back. You can work on this short cable, or you can carry that on your back and walk around all over the place.
So, for instance, at a sporting event like a rugby or a football match, you could run up and down
the
touchline without that on your back, too?
To the limit of this cable, yes, about 20 or 30 yards.
Looking ahead, though, Dave, I mean, can you see the day when we might not even need cables and a pack?
Oh, I think that's fairly certain, yes. We shall have a radio camera and with be able to record tape as well on the spot. Yeah.
Now, what sort of things can you do with this camera that perhaps you would find difficulty with the studio camera?
Well, I can probably move around you rather more quickly than somebody could with one of your studio cameras.
Watch the cable. I see. Watch the pack there. There you are. Fine. How about getting a very low shot? Can you do that? I'm not a very good subject for a camera, I'm afraid. Tell you what, go up and sit behind the news desk and let's see how the camera looks from there, from that position. Now try reading the news, Dave. Come back and show us it upside down, because I know that's a particular feature of the camera. Now, do I just stand still, do
you
I?
You just stay where you are.
Watch your dope fall. That's amazing. Tremendous. Tell you what, why don't you go off down the corridor?
Fine.
Take this backpack, because I've thought of an idea.
Okay.
Off you go. Sue, Mick, I've got an idea. I won't tell you what it is, but just follow
me. Come on.
All right, Doug.
Here we go. Dad! Come on, you two, let's go home.
Douglas!
What?
Don't you think we ought to finish the show?
I've only just started.
But with Dave's camera, we can walk out to the car park with him. First, bye, Tony.
Bye, Tony.
On Tuesday, when we return, there'll be a special Halloween special, and Peter Cushing will be reading the winner of the ghost story competition.
And I'm going to be doing some cooking.
Can you cook?
No.
Oh, we'll soon find out. There's your badge, because you've been such a smashing winner.
How were they able to make it so portable compared with the big studio cameras?
Well, what they did was to take the lens and just the other small pieces that go to producing the first part of the picture before it goes into the electronics, and putting most of the electronics into this box here, which can be carried on the back. You can work on this short cable, or you can carry that on your back and walk around all over the place.
So, for instance, at a sporting event like a rugby or a football match, you could run up and down
the
touchline without that on your back, too?
To the limit of this cable, yes, about 20 or 30 yards.
Looking ahead, though, Dave, I mean, can you see the day when we might not even need cables and a pack?
Oh, I think that's fairly certain, yes. We shall have a radio camera and with be able to record tape as well on the spot. Yeah.
Now, what sort of things can you do with this camera that perhaps you would find difficulty with the studio camera?
Oh, we're on the other way.
I can't pan left any further.
Is there anything else that you as a cameraman would like to see happen with this camera? I mean, anything that's missing as far as you're concerned?
Well, it's very heavy, and of course the size. We've got four in the studio, and from time to time you get really congested, you know.
Bump into one.
Yeah.
Of course, we mustn't knock it all together, because there is one marvellous thing about it, because what Rowley is seeing now, you are seeing at home immediately. There's no processing involved. Look, come and have a look. If you look through where Rowley's looking through, you can see what he's seeing, but the one thing is that it's missing manoeuvrability.
Well, Sue, I've got the manoeuvrable camera here. This one I can move anywhere. I can see anything in the studio. It's a film camera. It's the sort of thing that we use twice a week on Magpie when we're out on stories. The trouble with it is that although I can see anything, no one else can, because the film, which is in the magazine here, has to go off to be processed just like snapshots do. And that takes a few days, so this really isn't quite the answer, I'm afraid.
Perhaps this is, Mick, because this is a portable television camera. If you move out the way there, I'm not very used to it at the moment. It has almost all the flexibility of a film camera, yet you get live pictures. And if I pan all the way around the studio, standing on the same spot, you can see just how flexible and versatile it is. Although I'm not terribly good as a cameraman, but Dave Rogers, who's a senior outside broadcast cameraman, certainly is. There you are, Dave.
Thank you, David.
You were breathing heavily a bit there watching me.
I was, yeah.
Because it's quite a valuable camera now.
This is a television colour camera. It's pretty heavy. 208 pounds of brilliant, sophisticated mechanism. This is Rowley Luca. He is pretty heavy too, looking at him. I should reckon about 150 pounds of brilliant, sophisticated mechanism, right?
Right.
Anyway, the thing about this camera is that it is heavy, but it can do quite a lot of things. Let's test it, shall we? I'm going to walk round you, Rowley.
Okay, sir.
Twice, pretty fast. Can you follow me?
Yeah.
Right, here we go. I'll run, in fact. Come on, catch up.
That's it, I'm afraid.
Ah, you see, that is it. Because what happened?
Well, we've got this very heavy-duty camera cable, you see, that takes the power from the camera and to it. And it's got wound round the pedestal.
So you'd have to go...
Well, I can probably move around you rather more quickly than somebody could with one of your studio cameras.
Watch the cable. I see. Watch the pack there.
There you are.
Fine. How about getting a very low shot? Can you do that? I'm not a very good subject for a camera, I'm afraid. Tell you what, go up and sit behind news desk and let's see how the camera looks from there, from that position. Now try reading the news, Dave. Come back and show us it upside down, because I know that's a particular feature of the camera. Now, do I just stand still, do
you
I?
You just stay where you are.
Watch your don't fall.